Hello everyone, my name is Marc Garner. I'm the segment president for the cloud and service provider segment here at Schneider Electric. The power crunch is a challenge for everyone at the moment, and we have to, as an industry, start to think about how we adapt our behaviours and our activities to be able to support and address this looming power crunch that we have. It's a chance for us to innovate, to do things differently, not just in terms of how we design, build and operate data centres, but in how we work with the ecosystem and the system around the data centre. How do we work with the utility industries and do things differently, partner with them, share information at a much earlier stage in terms of where you want to build, how you want to build, and then look at alternative energy sources, renewable energies, on-site generation where possible, and really address these challenges that we have around the looming power crunch. At Schneider Electric, I will say, I do think this is overhyped. There are opportunities and solutions out there today that allow us to adapt and still build data centers, even in constrained areas and constrained geographies, with the technology that's available to us today. At Schneider Electric, we believe that AI is an opportunity for us to really drive sustainability. You could consider what's happened over the last 4 or 5 years and the conversations we've had around liquid cooling. Over the last year, 18 months, with the emergence of AI and the acceleration of AI, liquid cooling's turned from a concept and something that isn't widely adopted into something that's been adopted and driven into design and operation behavior. It's only going to accelerate going forward. And that's a great opportunity for us to reduce PUE, get it down to even lower levels than where we are today, and really accelerate energy efficiency within the data center. It's key that we take this opportunity to really look at operational technologies, systems like UPS, and how do we drive greater efficiency in the UPS performance. You'll notice at Schneider Electric, we've recently introduced the GVXL UPS, highest efficiency on the market, and it's key we keep pushing those boundaries and keep moving it forward. The same with transformers, with switchgear, with the systems that make a data center operate. We have to keep pushing those boundaries forward. The other thing I think is key is that AI is part of the solution, the fix going forward. We have management and monitoring systems across all buildings and all data centers. We have to start using that technology, that data we're getting from those systems, putting it into AI systems and AI programs to help drive efficiency around the operation of a data center, less manual, more automated, and better efficiency on the output from it. The final point I'd say is really around procurement and energy procurement, making sure that we're buying green, clean, using generation that's green and clean energy for all of our data centers in the future. AI is a huge opportunity to decarbonize beyond the data center industry and into buildings, manufacturing, into transportation. You think around all the data that we generate today at the moment and how we use that data. This is a great opportunity for us to really do something different with that data. Put it into a system that allows us to analyze it, address it, and really change the way that energy is being used through an automated system rather than a manual system. So AI has a huge role to play in decarbonizing industry outside of the data center as well as inside of the data center. If you think around manufacturing, transportation, buildings in general, they're all generating a huge amount of data that isn't really being used to its full capacity at the moment. AI gives you the potential to be able to take that data, interrogate it in a smarter, more intelligent way, and put some automation around how that data is used to drive greater building efficiency. So AI has a huge role to play in decarbonization, not just in the data center industry, but also in other industries and other applications. Think about manufacturing sites, transportation, commercial buildings. These all generate a huge amount of data that isn't being used effectively at the moment. AI has the opportunity to really interrogate that data, take that data back into a system, and really start to automate some of that behavior and how those systems and buildings work. Just think about a commercial building like we're in today. The HVAC system there's a huge opportunity for us to be able to drive automation through artificial intelligence to use that HVAC system in a far more efficient way. We've seen it in education, where we have a live case study where the carbon efficiency ratio is 1 to 60. So for every one output of carbon generated through the AI creation, you get 60 units of carbon back in saving through the application and through the benefit in the HVAC system. So a huge opportunity to use AI to drive sustainability. So this idea of bending the energy curve is really important. If you think about what's happened over the last 15 years, in 2010 to 2020, we saw the energy used in data centers stay broadly flat, whilst the amount of data being consumed over that same period went from 2 terabytes to 64 terabytes. So a huge amount of data being used and increasing over that period of time. But efficiencies in how the data center has been run and PUE reduction and new technologies being implemented has really helped to keep that flat. What's happened since 2020 going into 2024 is the energy curve has started to mirror that of the data curve. So the data curve is still increasing, doubling from where it was in 2020. Now the energy curve is going with that. And we need to do something to decouple it, to bend the energy curve away from that of the data curve. And there's some critical aspects in which we can do that. One is really looking at PUE. How do we reduce our PUE within the data centers? Beyond that, what's predicted in 2060 to 2030? We need to target as an industry getting down to around about 1.2 PUE, and then in existing infrastructure, really bringing around 10% of our existing infrastructure back down to 1.2 PUE as well. And then it's all about adopting ICT technology. New systems that are coming out, new infrastructure that are coming out from the compute side of things to really drive benefit in the data center and drive efficiency in the data center. If we can do both these things, we believe we can decouple the energy curve and bend that energy curve away, reducing around about 17% of energy consumption.